Hello, Alicia.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm really, really good.
I was not expecting to see you today. I've known Kojo for many, many years. Kojo, I'll let you tell my fellow judges about yourself.
I'm a stand-up comedian. Been doing comedy for 20 years. I've spent most of those 20 years encouraging young comedians and helping big name comedians and opening up for them. And my new fiance. We've got a little boy called Roman who's here as well. And she said that it was about time that I started thinking about myself and
my son.
Who makes you laugh?
Simon Cowell.
That's funny. Okay, well, look, Kojo, you know the show. 3 minutes, do your stuff.
Good luck, darling.
Thank you very much.
Come on, coach.
Rooting for this. I want a good one.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a new dad for the first time. But all I want to do is be better than my dad, right? My dad had no patience, right? Me and my best friend, Michael Murphy, after school every day, we'd play football on the estate. I had the parent who would ruin that game by calling me inside for something I didn't think was necessary. All you would hear, because I've got African parents, right? My dad would shout like, Kojo, come here. Now, Michael always had a confrontation with my dad. He was like, coach, what's going on, mate? Coach, you're a big man, you're 11. You go in there and you tell him that this enough's enough. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there was a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But then I remembered, he don't live in my house. So I turned to my dad, I said, Dad, what's up? Go to the store and get me Ribena. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all I said. Dad! Can't you get it yourself?
It was 1 p.m, but it got dark real quick.
The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have any jokes, I got problems. Have you ever been to a bank, right? Because I'm not really happy with the customer services that we get at banks nowadays, right? Have you ever gone into a bank? You've seen 4 available windows, 4! But there's only one person working. Yes. Then you get the woman that works there who walks past the queue and says, don't worry, she won't be long, go and help her! Why are you out here? You get to the cashier because it's your turn, right? They've now given the cashiers microphones, yeah? So everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm right here, I can hear you, right? And I'm already embarrassed about the amount that I need. So I was discreet, right? I was like, can I get £1.50, please? That weren't enough for her. She had to talk into the mic and get into my business. Sorry, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open? I'm like, why are you shouting? But I told you, I needed the rest of what was in my account. So I said to her, please, can I get that 50 pence? She said to me, how do you want that? I was like, in silence.
Nice.
I was so frustrated that I rushed out of the bank. I rushed out to be greeted by the most creative homeless person I have ever met. He rushed up to me and said, look, mate, I know you're in a rush, but can I please get 20 pence to get something to eat? Ladies and gentlemen, I looked at him and said, you know where to eat for 20 pence? I said, mate, I'm coming with you. I've got dinner for the both of us. When you're broke, right, and you ain't got no money, there's certain things that you can't enjoy. Like a cab ride, right? You can't enjoy the black cab ride. You can't enjoy it, right? I went into a black cab recently. Me and my mate, we jumped in. He was getting comfortable. Clearly, he's got more money than me. He was looking outside the window, talking to the driver. He fell asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, when you ain't got no money, you only look at one thing, the meter. The experience in a black cab is the most awful thing ever. They charge you before you even speak to the driver. You step in, 250. Hold on a minute. You sit down, £3. Hey! Let's discuss this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's got to a point where I don't even have a destination when I get into a black cab. When a driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5.
Very good.
My name's Kojo. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Kojo, when you came on, I loved hearing about how you've grafted, how you've honed your act, how you've now got your little family. Yeah, and the act just got better and better, and then by the end you were like, yeah, I'd pay money to see this man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much,
man. I'm so happy right now. I've always respected you. My respect level for you has just gone way up there, my friend. And let's see how far you can take it now.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you know, when someone's really funny, there is nothing much to say other than you are brilliantly funny.
Yeah.
You made everyone laugh. You've kind of got all bases covered as a comedian. You're brilliantly likeable. You've got fantastic observational routines. I think you did yourself really proud today.
Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Kojo, what was quite amazing was I felt that you were nervous. Then I could see the audience reacting to you and you reacting to them. But I'm going to be honest with you, Kojo, I don't really like comedians on this show. But I love you. I really get it.
I have to tell you, I don't know what it is. You are so funny and so unpredictable. You just got the most amazing energy. This is the break you've been waiting for.
Thank you so much.
I could not be happy with you.
Thank you.
Enjoy this.
So I just want
that.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
You look happy.
I am. I'm quite delighted. Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Daliso. Daliso Chaponda.
That's an amazing name.
That's a Malawian name.
Malawian.
Yes. So I'm from Malawi, but I live in Manchester.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
I've come to make the people laugh. I am a comedian.
Oh,
and
yes!
I'm a comedy writer.
I would love the winner of Britain's Got Talent this year to be a comedian.
Oh, no pressure.
No pressure.
Who are you here with?
So I'm here just alone. My brother, no, he wanted to come. He's a doctor. And he was like, either I should save lives or come with you.
Were your parents disappointed that one of you was a comedian, one of you was a doctor?
They were absolutely horrified because I was studying computer programming. So I had a future. And I just decided, no, let me be a clown. So we shall see.
Oh, darling, good luck.
Okay, excellent. Well, I'm at that age now, all my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their coupley problems. Always get, you are so lucky being single. I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, hey, I have to nag myself. I get home, I'm like, what time do I call this? Why don't I ever do the dishes? Sometimes I think I don't appreciate myself. I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo, left a Walkman. Took a plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. As I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago. And immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa. What are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? I have not seen one save the UK concert. You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when there are ads on television saying this chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. And 100%, you have got a financial crisis when India starts opening call centers here. Can you imagine some poor guy in Mumbai calls his bank, ends up talking to a Brummie? Thank you so much, Brummie.
I mean, laugh after laugh after laugh. It just kept on coming. And I really want you to win the entire series!
Thank you.
I think you could. And I think you have a golden future.
Oh, I thank do, you honestly. So much. I'm shocked and delighted.
So am
great.
I.
Wonderful.
My face is hurting from laughing. I'm so pleased that Amanda pressed a golden buzzer for you. You are brilliant, and I cannot wait to hear more from you. Well
thank
done.
You so much. Thank you very much.
You should be a comedy superstar.
Yes.
All the jokes were really original and you are incredibly likable. I couldn't fault it. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Well, not only do I think you're an undiscovered little star, I could see you owning your own show.
Thank you.
What you did was so funny and naughty and unique. This is why we make shows like this, to find people like you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much.
How about that?
That was awesome.
Just a bit.
He's so funny.
Like, we were crying. So.
Yes. The whole UNICEF thing, over throwing fish and chips out the window.
Well done, fella.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely brilliant.
Thank you. My brother.
See you live in the studio for the semi-finals.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Off you go. Celebrate.
Thank you so much.
What's it?
Is he here by accident? Hello. Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Matt Edwards.
Hi, Matt.
Hello.
Where are you from? Where are you from, Matt?
I'm from Suffolk.
Suffolk? Great.
Yes.
How old are you?
I'm 34.
34. Do you have a day job?
Do I look young?
I'm a magician, is what I do for my day job.
Lovely. So tell us something about you that makes you different from other magicians that we may have seen on the show.
I think what makes me different from other magicians is the type of magic I perform isn't necessarily sleight of hand. It's a little bit crazy, a little bit variety, I would say.
It's like the sound of that. All right, well, we look forward to your act. Good luck.
So I do it now?
Yeah.
It's lovely to meet you all. My name is Matt. What's your name? Brilliant, that's enough. Now, I've only got like a minute to show you what I can do, so ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to perform a trick, but before I do my trick, I'm going to propose a toast. I want to say cheers to everybody. So when I say cheers, everybody in the audience shouts...
Cheers!
Perfect, amazing. Now, because I've only got a minute, I'm going to give this a big build-up in the hope that everyone claps really loudly and then all the ladies take off their bras and throw them in my face. Looking at you, Alicia. Worth a try. So, ladies and gentlemen.
Señores y señores, bienvenidos a la Britain's Got Talent. Esta noche se va para la tequila. Rachel, I'm amazing.
Ba 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 ba.
Save Lee Evans and magic.
I like him.
I do.
Yeah. What's this? Might as well. I forgot the salt. Gotta have salt. Oh.
Tequila.
Forgot the salt. Hup. I'm fine, I'm fine. Sorry. No, brew. Sorry. Everybody, cheers!
Thank you.
Thanks. David.
Oh, what a brilliant way to present a magic trick.
It's good.
I love when people push jokes as far as they possibly can go until they almost break. It was very funny, very entertaining. It was brilliant. Well done.
Thank you.
Amanda?
Yeah, I mean, I really loved it. It was sort of silly how Tommy Cooper used to do it. You know, you're so distracted by you clowning and messing about that we're not paying attention to what you're actually doing, so therefore it's even more magical. I really love you. I think you're charming, I think you're funny, and you're kind of old school with a twist, which is absolutely perfect for Britain's Got Talent. Well done.
I've got to be honest with you, Matthew. You know, when you started with that voice, I thought this is going to be really annoying. But actually, you are brilliant. I mean, really, really funny. And how old are you, 34, did you say?
34.
Okay, I'm surprised you haven't had a break yet, Matthew, because you're really likeable and nuts. You've just got something about you. It's your energy. This is what we look for on these shows, people who've got star quality. I've just got a feeling about you.
Good, you know.
He's good. Really good.
I agree, Matthew. Love your passion and enthusiasm. Right, we're going to take a vote. David.
Oh, they've got the vote.
I'm going to say yes.
Yeah, hold on. Hold on.
Excuse me.
I wasn't expecting that.
Honestly, we were laughing so much, I thought I was going to pee myself. Really funny. Well deserved.
Honestly, we loved the act, and then Simon, you said it. He's 34 years old, and for some reason, he hasn't been given the break up until now. And so we just wanted to be there and do it.
Honestly, well done. Well done. Funny. Really good. Really good. Really good. Love it. Yes! That's a good one.
Yeah!
You picked a good one!
I've got to tell you, Matt, they were absolutely on the money. This is what it's all about. Dreams come true. Good for you.
You deserve it, man. Look at that. Look at that.
Thank you so much.
Loved it.
Oh,
honestly,
God.
That was just... Oh, I haven't seen energy in a routine like that for years.
Please tell us you've got those moments in your life.
It's not just the song,
I've got
thing, is it?
So much that I'm ready to show the world.
Good.
Thank you so much for the opportunity
you're
to show
you.
No.
Well, look, you're live straight through the semi-finals.
Oh my god.